want to take a moment to talk to you about storm cleanup. One of the questions that I most frequently get is, what do we do with trees that have blown over? In Vermont, we've had two big windstorms in the last few weeks, and it's blown over and broken off and leaned over tons of different trees. And every time that this happens, I get all these phone calls from people who think that they need to clean these trees up. So I want to really quickly debunk some of the misconceptions about storm cleanup and tell you what you actually should do. Now, if you're in the Northeast and you're not in an area where forest fires are a big concern, there is no amount of dead trees or dead wood on the ground that would be too much. Dead wood and the many habitats and benefits that it provides to forest ecology is something that we really need a lot of and that is very underrepresented in our modern forests. Those trees that are lying on the ground are not an impediment to wildlife travel. They are not a problem for forest health. They are not spreading diseases. They are as normal a part of forest ecology as living trees. And so other than our own sense of aesthetics, there's no ecological reason to clean those trees up. That said, that doesn't mean that there's no reason to clean them up at all. If those trees are a hazard, if they're endangering your home or your property, you can absolutely cut those trees up. If those trees are blocking a trail that you really like to use, my advice would be to reroute the trail. But if you can't reroute the trail, by all means, clear the trees off the trail, but just do that. You don't need to clear every tree in the woods, just clear the trees that have fallen enough so that you can pass through. Another thing that people don't realize as they try to do this storm cleanup is how incredibly dangerous fallen trees are. Trees like the one behind me are expert level chainsaw work. And the reason for this is that when they fall over and they're still attached to that root system, or they're even leaning over, there is all kinds of weird things that can happen when you cut that tree. One example of this is sometimes with a fallen tree, you'll cut the top off of it and the tree will spring back upright. Cutting the bottom of it is generally a safer approach, but even when you cut the bottom of it, it can shear in half, it can jump up in the air, it can do all kinds of things that can really hurt yourself. So a fallen tree that's on the ground connected to a root system is definitely not as easy as just cutting up a piece of wood on the ground. It should be done with extreme caution, and if you have the option, you should honestly avoid doing it at all. Another example of when you might want to clean up trees is that these are big, valuable trees. You've been growing them for a long time. Maybe you can sell those as saw logs and use that revenue to pay your property taxes or to invest in wildlife habitat improvements or other non-commercial work. Owning a piece of forest land is expensive, and the people who do it are providing benefits that we all enjoy. And so there's nothing wrong with capturing some of the value in those trees to offset some of the other costs of land ownership. What I would say about that is, again, use extreme caution and also salvage those trees minimally. Those trees that are pulp trees, that are firewood, that are low-grade trees, that aren't even really going to pay their way out of the woods, aren't worth the danger of harvesting them, and they can provide many other ecological benefits if you just leave them in place. Aside from mitigating hazards and capturing some of the value in those trees that have fallen over, the last reason why you might want to do some storm cleanup is if you have an invasive plant control problem where all those trees laying on the ground is actually going to interfere with your ability to control those invasive plants that are then going to explode in the aftermath of that windstorm. Some of the real benefits that come from this type of disturbance is from the regeneration that ensues. And if all that regenerates there is these non-native invasive plants, the healthier forest is going to be impaired, and a lot of those positive benefits won't be realized. So when a tree falls over naturally in the forest, we call that a tip up. And when it pulls its root system out of the ground, as it often does, we call that exposed root system a root ball. Soil conditions in old growth forests are really influenced by these tip ups. It creates what we call pit and mound microtopography, which is where we have this undulating soil, which is a result of over thousands of years, trees falling over, exposing that root system. The place where that root system pulled out of makes this little pit, this divot, which can be this cool sort of micro wetland. And where that root ball rotted down is a mound, which creates unique growing conditions, often for species like yellow birch that need disturbed soils to grow. These tip-ups also provide really great habitat for mosses and lichens. Birds like winter wrens will make nests on these root balls. Like many features in the forest that are not living trees, they're this incredibly important and also underappreciated part of forest ecology. So as you look at those fallen trees in your woods, think about how much storm cleanup is actually necessary, and think about leaving a lot of those trees to contribute to wildlife habitat and forest ecology. And of course, whatever you do, please, please, please be safe.